When you first set up a Microsoft 365 tenant, there are so many settings and different options that we need to set. But where do we have to start? In this series of videos, I'm going to walk you through all the settings inside Microsoft 365 tenant administrations. We start with the very basic organizational settings in this video, and in the future videos, we go into the advanced and more deep level settings and configurations. Join me on these videos to take a look at the organizational setting. Log into your Microsoft 365 Admin Center by going to admin.microsoft.com. From the Admin Center, click on Show All to see all the settings available. Once the list expanded, go to the Settings and select Organization Settings. This is where you can set up many of the general settings for your organization and some services and applications' default behavior. As you can notice, there are three tabs: Services, Security and Privacy, and Organization Profile. Let's start by looking at Organization Profile. Under Organization Profile, you can configure most of the generic behaviors of your tenant. First, you have the option to create a new custom application and add it to All Applications section for all the users. Your custom application can be a workflow on a company SharePoint site, or maybe a company portal itself. To create a custom app launcher, click on Add a Custom Tile, provide the information, and click Save. I will create separate detailed videos for all the settings mentioned here. If you would like, you can check the channel regularly or automate this process by hitting the bell icon to be notified when the new videos are released. Custom themes allow you to customize the look and feel for your users and how their Microsoft 365 page looks like. You can add company logo, change the color theme, and font colors. You can even have several different themes that apply to different groups. With that approach, your users in different departments see different colors with different logos. Data location shows which geographical location is your data hosted. You won't be able to change it from here, and it's mostly for reporting and informational purposes. Under the Help Desk information, you can add your company's help desk information so your users know who to contact when they need help. This will save a lot of time for your users and your team. Keyboard shortcuts shows you the shortcuts for some of the most commonly used actions like adding a user, contact, or resetting a password for a specific user. Under the organization information, you can add your company's information like address, phone number, location, and many more. Release preferences is where you can choose how your organization gets new features and services updates from Office 365. Furthermore, there is a link for the settings that affect how Office applications receive updates. Last setting under the organization profile gives you the option to integrate your existing ticketing system with Microsoft 365. By doing this, reporting an incident will automatically open a ticket in your ticketing system as well. Let's move on to Security and Privacy tab. Under Bing Data Collection, you can decide to allow or disallow Bing to collect information about your organization's search behavior. With Customer Lockbox, you can require additional security for accessing data. When enabled, guests or Microsoft technicians who are trying to connect to your tenant and use data such as SharePoint shares or analytics data will need to wait for an approval from your organization before they can access data. Just a gentle reminder that there would be more videos coming up about these settings. Moving to the next item, we have idle session timeout. One of the most important and must configure settings on your Microsoft 365 tenant is idle session timeout. When you set this value, your users would be signed out if they are inactive for the set amount of time. You can use the predefined values in hour or set your own value in minutes. It is highly recommended to set this value and make sure users are signed out of the web applications if they are inactive. Next setting is password expiration policy. Here you can decide if the passwords are set to expire or allow them to never expire. Apart from test and development tenants, it is best to make sure the passwords will expire. Your next setting is privacy profile. This is where you include a link to your corporate privacy policy document. It is usually a website published and accessible through the internet. You only need to include the link to that address. Your second most important security setting must be privileged access. Privileged access is when you would like to delegate a role or a task to a specific user for a specific duration of time. Let's say you want to allow a user to be able to set mailbox forwarding rules without giving them Exchange administrator rights. You can create a policy and a rule and assign the desired permissions. The user then can request access for a specific period of time, gain access, complete the task, and release the permissions. The permissions would be removed automatically once the period of time is passed. To make it more interesting, all the activities are logged and recorded. Our next security setting is related to self-service password reset. With the settings in this section, you can enable users to reset their passwords if they forget their current password. This can be done without involving your help desk. Users can reset their own passwords. They only need to memorize a few security questions. This page will take you to Azure portal for the setup and requires specific licenses, which I will cover in more details on separate videos. Last setting on this page is related to sharing. You can control access for people from outside your organization by allowing or disallowing your users to invite guests from other Microsoft 365 tenants. You can allow users to share files with external people and invite guests, or you can limit the invitation of guests to administrators only. Last tab is services. This is the tab where you can change the settings related to most of the services and apps offered by Microsoft 365. To name a few of these settings in this tab, we can look at multi-factor authentication and Office installation. To keep this video short, I will create a separate video for this tab and all the services and settings here. And if you've made it so far, you're probably interested in learning more. Head out to the channel and consider hitting the bell icon to be notified when the new content is released every week. Thank you for watching and see you on the next video.